afternoon. This is Lynda Cromar. I'm coming to you from Colorado. And as you can see, I've got this little banner. I just put it up on Facebook on purpose so I could about this very important issue. I see it over and over and over again. It doesn't seem like anybody ever gets it, that Facebook straight out is not for selling. They don't even want you to use your profile as a place to sell. But it's one of the most lucrative places to sell if you learn how to do it right. And what do I mean by that? I mean that when you have the ability to put people first and take the time, like I put on my banner, to actually ask them questions and make them, you know, let them know that you actually care. When you get a solicitation, either in person or if you get it on an email or in a chat, your first reaction is to push back and say, no, thank you. But if somebody is being very helpful to you in a long-term period of time, actually wants to help you, actually cares about what your problems are enough that they are going to ask questions, and even if it turns out, and it does at times, that what they have does not solve their problem, then that person becomes more valuable to that other person, and they're more likely to say, you know what, I like you, I want your link, let's get together. And I've had that happen many, many times. It's not a coincidence that it has happened most of the time because I've taken the time to get to know people. Some of you have even probably gotten chat messages from me because I'm looking to try to really, truly connect with you and to actually take the time to find out what you're all about. And it's not about, I want to pitch your my business to you. In fact, the link that's on that graphic that I showed at the beginning is my newsletter. And what my newsletter has in it is I share good marketing tips every single day. I do have a little handout, a free little booklet, Simple Freedom booklet, which teaches how to make money on the internet the right way. That's available just for getting on the newsletter, which is marketingwithlynda.com. Marketingwithlynda.com. It's real simple. And, of course, my name's not spelled L-I-N-D-A. You know, just simple things like that. Now, if you think about it, when you talk to somebody in, you know, in live instead of on Facebook or in a chat, you make an effort to actually get acquainted with them and to learn their name and to say their name correctly. So the same thing goes with chat messages. If you think about it, if you actually think about what their name is spelled like, is it spelled different than normal? Because often that is the case. People do actually spell your name differently. Mine is spelled with a Y, not an I. And the very quickest way to actually make higher rapport with people, this is just a big hint because I see people spelling my name L-I all the time. And I don't get offended. It's just that it shows me that person didn't truly take the time to realize that my name was spelled differently, and it's already on the top of that chat window, so it's not like they don't know or they can't see it. It's because they didn't take the time to realize that my name was spelled with a Y. Now, this happens all the time with a lot of people in all kinds of, you know, it doesn't matter, you know, there's different spellings for different names. For instance, Eric could be spelled with a C or it could be spelled with a K. Take the time to realize that that person's name is important. When you realize their name is important and you take the time to actually spell it correctly, because the only impression you're going to make is the things you say in the very first couple of conversations. And chats is only text, so it's only one way that that person actually gets to find out what you're about. And if you don't take the time to actually care about them enough to find out what their name is, Find out how it's pronounced. Find out how it's spelled. Take that time. Ask them questions. Look at their profile. I mean, don't ask questions you couldn't find out by looking at their profile, because a lot of the time it's pretty obvious what their interests are, or whether they have a family. Those kind of things are already on their profile. It might be in a picture. It might be because they wrote down, oh, I have a relationship, I have a wife, I have a husband. If you take the time to actually care about that person first, before you care about, I want you to look at my business, you might have a better chance at them saying, yeah, I want to know about that because I could tell that you cared. Now, they may not say it that way. They may not even know that that's why they feel that way. But I can tell you, if you take the time to actually care about the other person. Like, I put up a post today and I said, is it important to you to see the results somebody is having, or would you rather have some join somebody because you trust them first? And everyone that answered me said that trust mattered. And how do you establish trust? Most of the time, that's established by the fact that you take the time to care about them first. For instance, I'm not offering you a capture page over to my business. In fact, I'm not even going to tell you what my business is today. It's about relationship. And I'm going to share with you more good stuff on my newsletter, and that is marketingwithlynda.com. So I invite you to just jump on and enjoy the messages I send every day. And that ebook I told you about, that's going to come to you immediately once you join. And again, this is just a newsletter. It's not a business, because I don't believe in giving people my business on the first contact. I think they need to get acquainted with me first. They need to have a time to trust and to decide by how I'm being with them. And when you do that, you have a better chance of that person eventually saying yes. But I can tell you one thing, you lose them real quick if you give them a link that goes directly to your business on the very first contact. You've lost that chance of ever having an opportunity to get better acquainted, to find out what their needs are, to even see if they have an interest, because you went way too fast and you made it about you instead of about them. I hope that's been helpful. You really can sell on Facebook if you know how. And I've had a lot of fun doing that. And you can get on my newsletter at marketingwithlynda.com. Talk to you later. Bye for now.